The goal of our lab is to understand how embryos form the morphologies of their organs. We're relying heavily on fluorescence microscopy and specifically light sheet microscopy, which allows us to image these processes so we could see exactly what's happening at every second. And then we're taking these movies to computers so we could build a clear narrative, so we could come up with smarter hypotheses about what the tissue is doing, and at the end to take that back to the bench so we could actually test that using, for example, genetic manipulations. A few years ago, the school has made a decision to pioneer the integration of the experimental skeletal and dental biology together with data science. Having been one of the best schools in the world, it can offer us the opportunity to work with some of the leading figures in the field. I decided to pursue a career in scientific research because this is more or less the only job in the world where you have the ability to choose the questions that you're working on regularly and to incorporate as much creativity as you want. This way I get to be surrounded by extremely intelligent students who are eager to learn and bring their own ideas into the research. While our studies are focused on skeletal biology, we're also studying tissue organization and morphogenesis in the early fruit fly embryo, and we're also developing computer algorithms for biological image analysis for general purpose. And so it's not that the school is allowing us to do these extra things, it's encouraging us to do that because of this underlying philosophy that, you know, by integrating different disciplines of maybe even seemingly unrelated science, you can come with new and unexpected synergies that will help you to reach the next important discovery in the field. Currently, we know of nearly 500 skeletal dysplasias in humans. These conditions can lead to bones being shaped abnormally, which potentially results in varying degrees of reduced mobility. Now, understanding the development of the skeletal system is very crucial because it provides a much better foundation for understanding how developmental pathologies evolve and potentially allow us to identify therapeutic targets for them.